been following the channel for the past 6 months or so, you know that I've kind of rediscovered my love for comic books, and I finally purchased some again. I've been getting them from the library and things like that, but this past weekend, this local guy who sells comics basically out of his house, he had a big 50-cent comic book sale, and so I took my kids and we went to check it out. I couldn't be happier with the selection. He had thousands of books, all different varieties. He had one room that was just, you know, more independent labels, and then he had another room that was just DC and Marvel. And I gotta say, he had more Marvel than anything else. But it's weird because what got me back into wanting to read comic books again was a feeling of nostalgia. And it wasn't just the comic book movies that have been out, because they've been out for 10-plus years, and I haven't had the urge to read comic books, but I saw some graphic novels of the Age of Apocalypse at the library a couple months ago, and that sparked my interest, right, because that was one of my favorite series from when I was a kid. I haven't bought any comic books since then. I've been reading some from the library, and I went to this comic sale thinking, hey, maybe I can find a couple of those books that I had, you know, when I was a kid. If you don't know the story, I had a pretty good comic book collection for, you know, I was 15, 16 years old, and I had probably around 1,200 comic books, and mostly X-Men and Wolverine comic books. Wolverine is my all-time favorite character, and that was actually the first comic book I ever bought. It was Wolverine number 95. When I was about 12 years old, I think. When it first came out, I bought it off the newsstand, and I was hooked on comic books. I lost all of my original collection from when I was a kid. Our house was foreclosed on, and I lost all, like, everything. Not just my comic books, but, like, everything I had. But I went to this comic book sale, hoping to find, you know, just a couple of those books that I had back then. Not the super expensive books, but just the run-of-the-mill, you know, Wolverines and X-Men's that aren't worth a whole lot of money, but mean a lot to me because I loved reading them when I was a kid. But when I got there, I immediately went looking for the Wolverine comics, right? And I was blown away because he had a couple early issues of Wolverine, and he had a couple late issues of Wolverine, but the bulk of the Wolverines that he had in his collection there was the exact era that I collected them when I was a kid. And so I actually was able to find Wolverine number 95, and that's part of what I'm about to show you now. I'm going to go ahead, this will be the first time I've ever done this, okay, because I haven't collected comic books in many years, but I'm kind of starting over, and I have some specific goals, you know, of what I want to collect. I want to collect every issue of Wolverine. That means the four-part initial miniseries, and then the, I think it's 183 standalone Wolverine books that came in the Volume 2 of the Wolverine saga, I guess. Anyway, so I looked through his collection, and he keeps good care of them. I don't know, you know, where he acquires all of them, probably all over the place. This guy has awesome finds. This guy has some stuff in his own collection, his personal collection, like X-Men number 1 from 1966. So if you know anything about comics, that's like a really big deal. Like, he showed me that. He said, this is my crown jewel. Okay, then he whips out Incredible Hulk number 181, which is the first appearance of Wolverine. Wow. That, like, these are books I only saw in, like, Wizard magazine when I was a kid. The first appearance of Venom, first appearance of Punisher, like, he had some really cool books. But in his 50-cent sale, I was able to find a lot of exactly what I was looking for. So I'm going to share with you what I found in my very first comic book haul, and then also some of the other books I picked up that my kids picked out for themselves. And I'm really excited that the kids are finding, you know, taking an interest in comic books, because it's something I loved as a kid, and maybe that's something, you know, more that we can bond over. So here we go. (Clears throat) So first I'll show you what I picked up for me. Wolverine number 46. Wolverine number 57. Sorry, there's a pretty bad glare there. Wolverine number 62. Wolverine 81. And now we get into where I was collecting them when I was a kid. These are very nostalgic books for me. Wolverine number 90. This is the one where Wolverine puts a claw into Sabretooth's head and it breaks off in there. Really cool book. Wolverine number 91. Number 92. What is this? 94. Is the Generation X guys on there? And this is what inspired me to actually purchase comics that day. If I wouldn't have seen this, I don't think I would have bought any. This was the very first comic book I ever bought back in 1995. Wolverine number 95. The first comic book that the cover just leaped off at the shelf and I had to buy it. So, I just thought it was so awesome that I could find that one, and basically I can say that Wolverine number 95 was the first comic book in my collection, and back in 1995, and now, all over again, it's the first book in my collection, round two. So, really cool. Let's see. Wolverine 96. And what I'm really hoping to, well, I'll talk about it in a minute. There's 96. 97. And then we jump to 101. Now, some of my favorites when I was a kid were 99 and 100. So I'm really hoping to find 99 and 100. And there were a couple books I didn't pick up because they weren't in sleeves. But I think I'm going to examine them a little better the next time he has a sale and possibly pick those up. Because I'm not really in this for collecting them for the money that they're worth. I'm collecting them because I want the whole collection. I want the series, and I want to be able to read it and have that series to look at all those covers, you know. Because there's plenty of ways to read the entire series without having each individual book. I can read in graphic novel form. I can read it online. I can read it in the big graphic novels that are the Essential Wolverines. They come in black and white. But I really want the original books. I really want them. So, I've got 103. Another copy of 103. I think that was an accident picking that up. I'll keep the one that's in better shape. 105. And this is kind of... After 100 is when he went feral, and, you know, he was really wild looking. The art got a little strange. Like, for me, I didn't like that feral stage very much, but they changed artists, and after 100, it just got strange. I didn't like it. I didn't like the feral Wolverine, but who knows, maybe this time around I'll appreciate it more. I don't know. I just didn't enjoy the artwork as much. And then we have number 106. Keep in mind, I bought these all for 50 cents, and as you can see... in pretty good condition. This camera is not the best because I have it zoomed in. But, and then here's some that the kids picked up. This is, I don't know much about them because they're all like weird editions and stuff like that. But you got this Ultimate Spider-Man. It says issue 18, The Cycle. I don't know what The Cycle is, but. You got, And this is just the stuff that, you know, the kids have seen the movies, so they're getting into stuff. This is a Guardians of the Galaxy. One of them picked up this Ion Guardian of the Universe, which I've never read. I don't know what that is exactly. And then both of the boys really enjoy, they're 7 and 8 years old, by the way. Both of the boys really enjoy Black Panther. They love the movie, and so it has inspired them to buy the books. Here's the New Avengers. And, you know, next time I do one of these, I'll get a better camera for you. Alright, this is Captain America. It says first issue. This is November 1996, so this must have been a, I don't know which volume, but it says Captain America first issue. Avengers Forever. And then this was the coolest thing. Not only did these books were 50 cents, but the guy, dude, he just saw the passion that I had to get back into comic books, and he saw how much the kids wanted to read these books, and he said, tell you what, because I had probably 20, 30 bucks worth of comics there, and he said, I'll tell you what, I'll give it to you for 10 bucks as long as the kids promise to actually read the books. I said, dude, you got a deal. The kid said, deal, we'll read the books. He gave me all those books for $10, and then not only that, but he saw that, you know, trying to interest the kids in something that obviously this guy and I both have a passion for. Him much, much more than me. But he goes, hey, I forgot. I've got an entire box. Got an entire box of free Comic Book Day comics. This box is full to the top with comics that he has collected over I don't know how many years. I'm not going to go through all of these. But, and they're not in sleeves or anything. They're all free Comic Book Day books. And even though they're not in sleeves, they're all pretty good condition. Hip Hop Family Tree. But there's a lot of books here. There's probably 100 books in here, I would say. And he just gave those to us. Just gave them to us. Like, what a cool guy, man. Like, dude, that right there has earned repeat business. I'm going to be back every time he has one of these sales. Like I said, he sells them out of his house, and he does it, you know, a few times a summer. Basically, it's called Bean's Garage Sale Comics. It's basically, it's a garage sale for comic books, and he has, like, a two-part garage just full of comic books. Full of them. All in sleeves, all in great condition, and he gets new ones in all the time, so I'm definitely going to go back every time he has a sale, especially these 50-cent sales. Like, that's amazing. I saw Spawn number 1 there. That's another series that I want to collect all of. I want all the Wolverine series, and I want all of the Spawn series. One that I had when I was a kid, and I want to get again, is Spawn number 1. And he had it there for like 20 bucks. So that's pretty good. As long as it's in good condition, that's a good find, because I think it's worth like 30, something like that. But yeah, anyway, that's it. That's totally nerding out here. I figured, why not? Like, this is the channel where I say I do whatever I want on this channel. The videos are about whatever I want them to be about. Could be random as hell. And this is another fine example of it. I'm going to start sharing my comic hauls. Whenever I do go buy some comic books, which won't be all the time. But when I do, I'm going to share them with anyone who might be interested in the comic books that I acquire. So anyway, if you're interested in that, please like the video, subscribe for more, because I will be doing more of these as I collect more comics again. Join me on my journey to collect every Wolverine book from 1 to 183. And yeah, if you're into that type of thing, or if you're into movie reviews, series reviews, pop culture stuff, other nerd stuff, Star Wars, yeah, subscribe for more, because that's what I do. I just talk about whatever the hell I want to talk about, whenever the hell I want to talk about it. And that's what the channel's about. All right. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.